Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to start off with a question. Who in this audience is married? Don't be shy. Thank you. And a second question for all the other people. Who thinks that one day he or she might someday get married? Okay. Probably about 90% of you have something to do with marriage. The other 10% can now take out their iPhone and go start do something else. The 90% should pay close attention to me. What I'm about to say, very, very important. You can even take notes. It's only 9 minutes, so be aware. What happens with this marriage? I'm going to tell you about this marriage in the Netherlands, give you a few facts. I'll then tell you that there is a problem, that there's a problem with 90% of you. There's something rotten in the state of Holland, ladies and gentlemen, for those married or getting married. And then, finally, hopefully, I'll give you a solution. A solution reached in The Hague with the aid of, well, quite extensive research that has been done at this very university. So let's start off with marriage and with a few simple facts. These are A and B, and as you can tell, they are madly in love. Madly, utterly in love. All the married people can relate to this. This is what it looks like. And now, what happens is they will get married, and that looks like this. From a legal point of view, that is. Of course, you thought of something completely different, but this is marriage, legally speaking. A has some of his or her assets for herself. A and B have something communal, a community of property right in the middle there, and B has some aspects, some assets, also some debts of himself. So far, so good, no problem, not very exciting. So let's have disaster strike. That's what we lawyers love to do, not just have some people get married. No, something has to happen. Let's assume B, it's called B not because it's a beloved husband or best hubby. No, let's say B goes bankrupt. That's what we love as lawyers. Let's have somebody go bankrupt. Then you know what you have. At least B knows what he has, nothing. But A does. A, in this system, still has some assets of herself. Except for in one tiny country that you all know, 17 million inhabitants, and their marriage looks like this. This is what we call a universal community of property. Looks very romantic, I agree. Might even light a candle, or maybe even have the rector play a little romantic piano here. But let's kick in with this. Bankruptcy. B goes bankrupt. Can you tell where A is? Where A's assets are? Everything goes down the drain. Nothing is left. And still, you could argue, well, where's the problem? There's no problem here. These people know what they're doing. Somebody ought to have told them right before they entered into this marriage that this could be what they would end up with. Okay, let's put that to the test. Are you warned? Well, you are warned in everyday life on very many occasions. Say, in 10 minutes from now, you'll go and buy a bag of potato chips at the Albert Heijn. You'll be warned. 33% fat, 19% of which saturated. Okay, I'm warned. If I have other habits, I may be warned as well. By the government. This is quite clear, I would say. But now I meet this beautiful lady. And yes, if you're wondering, it is my wife. But no warnings. No warnings. a universal community of property. Everything goes down the drain. There's a problem. And maybe we could say that's only half the problem. In the beginning, we've seen some healthy aging. Well, let's do some healthy aging, but then in law, and there it has disastrous effects. This is healthy aging, this is Europe. The tiny lines are Europe now, the population. The bold lines are in about 50 years from now. People are getting married then, but then at a much older age. What will happen? Well, we can already tell. Well over 1,000 people got married in their 70s in 2011 in the Netherlands. Well over 100 got married in their 80s. You could say, okay, let them be. Of course. But were they warned? Was it a universal community of property? There are some very, very preposterous cases at the Supreme Court of the Netherlands already. I'll show you one. This case was about a 21-year-old marrying his grandmother's sister. For love or for the universal community of property? It's quite horrible, you could say. Now let's have a solution ready. Is there one? We could also say, well, why a solution? Is there a problem? It's just a great tradition that we have here. A great tradition, the universal community of property. Just let it be, like Black Pete. But I think that's a fallacy. A tradition, let's keep the tradition because it's a tradition. No. So maybe it's time for a change. Maybe we should have a limited community of property. And yes, there is a bill pending, as I said, after extensive research done at this university. And the bill is pending. Let's hope, all of us, let's hope that it's going to pass into law. And then for the people that are going to get married, my advice is, please wait. Please hold your horses until this is law. Because you do not want a universal community of property. If you do, your marriage might end up involving three rings: the engagement ring, the wedding ring, and the suffering. Thank you for your attention.